I assumed that I was not a good writer because I was not a good speaker. The things that I was going to say had to be repeated in my head at least 2 times before I actually said them. I was at war with my words, constantly putting them aside and letting them rehearse themselves over and over again in a never-ending revision process. In conversation, I did not have the luxury of chewing over my thoughts. Poetry was a way of translating my thoughts into words, like there was some instant messaging going on between my brain and my writing hand. I could scribble down all the thoughts that came to my head, so that it became a challenge of trying to weave them together. In poetry, my thoughts no longer seemed to be things that were in no way related to each other, but puzzle pieces I could lay out on the table and move around until I saw fit. For me, poetry was a way of creating my voice and proving that it existed, and exploring the things I was struggling to articulate. I was able to work through my thoughts, emotions, and capture the minute details of experiences. I was able to take parts of my surroundings and distill them in ways that would help me understand both myself and the world around me better. I could return to thoughts that I felt could be said better and develop them. And through all my years of loving writing, it has taken me this long to learn that spoken word is the best representation of me. Poetry addresses the notion of life and art as a constant performance. It is an art that is constantly developing through conversation, but it does not just stop there. It is an opportunity for a girl who has trouble communicating her thoughts to put together what she means. It has reminded her that she is a writer and has only extended the conversation.